this wave, we're introducing knowledge management directly in the Field Service app. Some folks may be familiar with our existing knowledge management feature that has existed for a long time with customer service. We're bringing this capability directly down to the work order level for technicians who are out in the field. So the idea would be, if I'm a tech out in the field, now I'll be able to have right in my hands while I'm on site, the knowledge that I need to help resolve an issue that I might previously have had to leave and not be able to solve the issue, which obviously is the worst case scenario for any field service scenario. You know, if I send somebody all the way out there and they can't solve the problem, then it's incredibly expensive and frustrating for your customers. So let's talk about sort of creating an article and then associating that to some of our records here. So we have knowledge articles in the system. If we look in settings and field service settings, so the settings area, and then we have the knowledge articles. So if we go to knowledge articles, we'll see the list of articles which are in various states. Let's take a look at the one that we're going to use for our scenario today. So we've created this article for this wine press, which has a bunch of content in there that, you know, folks are going to find useful as they're out on site. What's especially helpful now, so we can associate this content that has been created to a bunch of levels within the field service system. It can be related to, you know, work orders directly. It can be related to our assets. It can be related to products. It can be related to incident types. And as always, it can still be related to a case. And so when we create a work order that's related to any of those things, though, the knowledge that is associated to those records would flow directly down to the work order level, so that the technician has all of that right there for him, and he doesn't have to try to find it. So in this case, let's go ahead and create or associate this article to the main wine press at Coho Winery. So I'm just going to associate it to the main wine press. If I wanted to, I could also, I could associate it to the incident type, which is related to, to wine maintenance or whatever. From that record directly, I could also associate it. So, you know, we're able to do it here from the article. I can associate the article to the asset, or from the asset, I could associate the asset to the article. So whichever comes first. You can associate it to the you can make sure that knowledge is related to these key pieces of your data and the organization and the environment. All right, so now I've got on this main wine press for Coho Winery, I've got this article associated. So if we go ahead and raise a work order related to this wine press, so let's go ahead and create a new work order for Coho Winery. And we'll pick our monthly juicer maintenance, and we're going to go ahead and pick our main wine press asset. So then let's go ahead and pick preventive maintenance price list as well. So save that. So what we're going to get asynchronously is our knowledge article showing up here on the work order. So if we look at the knowledge article, we can see all the content that's here that's available to the technician, to anybody who's working on this asset. If I go ahead and book this, I'll book it to Abraham, $350. So this is booked to Abraham. So now if I switch over to Abraham on my mobile device here, so we can see here that Abraham's been booked on our wine press maintenance, monthly juicer maintenance work order. And if we look under service, so we can see all the information under service that we would always see. But in addition, we now see some linked articles. And if I click on that linked article, so the content that we share works, the articles that we share work both online and offline. So the technician, regardless of whether they're currently connected, would have access to the content to help them resolve these work orders. One thing worth noting is that currently articles only work in online, knowledge article images only work in online mode. So if you're not seeing an image, just make sure that you're in online mode. The idea behind this is that, you know, at the when I create a work order, the most important content related to that work order, whether it's coming from products that are associated to this work order, assets that are associated to the work order, incident types that are associated to the work order, or the case that originated this work order, any article that might have been associated to any of those pieces of information would flow directly down to the work order. So the technician would have all of that available to them while they're out there on site trying to solve the problem. You know, really, that's the key capability that we're enabling here. We've worked really closely with the knowledge management team to make sure that the knowledge articles are easily consumable, whether you're online or offline. And making sure that these knowledge articles are in read mode. For the technicians, that's really easy to consume, and that that if you're online and you're authoring the articles as a back office staff, that it's super easy to author that article and publish it so that it's available for the tech in the future. One of the things that we're doing on the mobile app is surfacing the knowledge articles that are related to. Well, it's all knowledge articles at the moment. We're working towards having a more specific filter, which will only surface knowledge articles that are related to your work orders. But at the moment, it would sync all the knowledge articles that are in the whole environment. Against that work order, it's only going to show the knowledge articles that are linked. We don't show directly from the mobile app all of the associated article. You know, you couldn't just scroll through all the articles today. We aren't adding an additional navigation item for knowledge articles the idea is to make it as easy as possible for the tech. So it's just available to them right from the work order. They shouldn't have to search for it. If they have to search for it, we're making it easier than that. We're hopefully making it right available for them immediately. We will automatically associate articles that come from, in this case, we saw obviously that this was related specifically to the asset that we related it to. So it got that article association automatically. It would also have picked up articles that were associated to the incident type if there were any. If this work order had originated from a case and that case had knowledge articles, those knowledge articles would also be available at the work order level. Finally, the last place where we pick up knowledge articles are products. So if you have a number of related products, and any of those have knowledge articles, perhaps installation guide or something, those would be available at the work order level as well. But to your point, you can link an article directly. So if you say add existing, brings up this this really cool, really powerful search control for knowledge articles. And then you can search for an article. So if we want to search for our wine press, we can link it here. In this case, it's already linked. We can see that it's already linked. If I wanted to, I can unlink it, or I can link other articles. So let's look for if I wanted to link this article, I could link it. It would show up as linked to the work order now. We'll see here that we have multiple linked articles. 3D models. We've supported association of 3D models against assets for a long time. So you can always use that functionality that's existed for at least a couple of years now, where you associate a 3D model to an asset. At the moment, uh, we we aren't trying to do anything special around 3D models associated to articles, but it is a good question. And if there's interest, if there's a bunch of demand for direct association of 3D models to the article itself, that would definitely be something we'd be interested to enable, but not something we're doing at the moment. There are no special behaviors between CS and FS. One thing that we do right out of the box in FS, I suppose, is that we enable automatically in article. Sorry, we enable knowledge against assets, products, incident types, and work orders. So when you install field service, those are automatically enabled for knowledge, which then means you can associate knowledge articles at those levels. And then in addition to the standard sort of article association capabilities that knowledge management brings, within field service, we have logic that will bring all of those associations down to the work order level based on the associations to the work order of those key entities. So asset, incident type, product, case. So by default, those associated articles would flow to the work order level directly, so that, like we said, we make it as easy as possible for the technician to pick those things up and do their work.